So Google has finally caught up with AI coding with its new model, Gemini 2.5 Pro. It was released last week and it is fantastic when it comes to coding. In fact, it's so good that in the first prompt itself, you can actually get something really functional. That's been my experience and it's been very, very impressive. And in this video, what we are going to do is keep it actually very, very simple. And this is targeted towards non-developers and people who have heard about vibe coding, don't have any idea what it is, people who have never written a single line of code or used an IDE and want to get started with something very, very simple. What we are going to do is that we are not going to use any IDEs. We are simply going to use the chat interfaces. And what we are going to do in this video is compare two models, that is Claude 3.7 Sonnet and Gemini 2.5 Pro. What we'll do is create a simple and modern looking paint tool, and we're going to compare the results of these two. So we are in the new Claude interface, and before we start, let me clarify a few things. If I go to the settings page here in Claude, I have actually given a rule, which is I typically write code in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript as a single file. So the code will anyway be in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript in a single file. But most importantly, I have toggled off the artifact feature. The reason is that currently when you're working with artifact, it can get really buggy. It will start editing codes in the wrong places and stuff like that. So we don't need any of those problems. So we are going to just make sure that the artifact feature is not on. We are toggling it off. Okay. So I will just create a new chat. Okay. Without the artifact feature. And for Gemini 2.5 Pro, we are not going to gemini.google.com, but rather we are going to aistudio.google.com. And in here, we will select this model. Okay, we have all these options here. We're going to select Gemini 2.5 Pro Experimental 0325. We are going to select that. Okay, and here I'm going to say, build me a full featured paint tool or app that has swatches and all the modern features that you can think of. It should have a very, very modern design and should look really, really cool. Okay, so we have the prompt. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to run it here and go to Claude. Here, I'm going to paste the exact same prompt and I'm going to just run it. So we are using 3.7 Sonnet here, and you can see without the artifact, it will start coding in the message itself. So what we'll have to do is we'll have to copy it from here and go to codeviewit.com and we'll paste it here. Okay. So this might seem a little tedious, but to be frank, it is better to do it this way as long as the artifact feature is buggy. Okay. And we don't have an artifact feature in Google AI Studio. We do have a feature like artifact in Gemini. So if I go to gemini.google.com, you can select 2.5 Pro Experimental here and you can select Canvas. The problem though is that this is probably not the exact same model. It seems to be not performing the same way as it does here. Okay. So it still has not completed here. And I'm sure Claude will require multiple messages to finish the code because it will be really, really large. So yeah, Claude has hit its max length. So let's do one thing. Let's say continue. Okay. And that's straightforward. You just hit continue and it will continue exactly from there. So we'll have to remove this section and start from there. Okay. So it's a pretty simple process. I will copy this code from here, the first message. Okay. I'm going to copy that. I'll go to codeviewit.com and I'm going to paste it here. Now, this is not complete code, so we cannot see anything. Let's go back to Claude. Let's do one thing. I'm going to open another tab of CodeViewIt. Okay, so coding is completed in AI Studio. I'm going to copy this. I'll go here and I'm going to paste it just like that. Okay, and I'm going to preview it. This is how it looks. So let's go to the full screen and this is what we have. That's interesting. So let's see. So we have a brush here. I'm going to use this color. And okay, it's drawing. Okay, let's select this one. So I can erase it. I just don't know where the mouse is. That's the only issue. So we have brush sizes. I'm going to increase the size and draw it there. That works. Opacity. Opacity is also working, which is great. Let's draw a line with opacity. That works. Circle. Yes, that works too. We have a square. That also works. Okay, that works. We have undo. Yes, that works. And redo also works. We have clear canvas. It will clear the canvas. Okay. And it will also save it. Great. So a fabulous start for Gemini 2.5 Pro. Okay, so let's go back to Claude and see if that has completed. Let's come all the way down. It's long. Wow. So I'm going to say continue again. Okay, so that will continue. I'm going to copy the second message from here. I'll go and I'll come back here just to show you what I'm doing. Okay, we'll have to start from here. This path DM18, right? The same thing here. So we'll have to replace this one. So I'm going to go here and select this one. Okay, I'm going to select all of that and delete that and then paste this code here. Okay, and finally it's completed. I'm going to copy it. I'll go up just to see which portion should be removed. So function get pixel color, you can see it here. So we can remove this section and paste it there. Okay, I'm going to go here and come down. I'm going to select that and just paste it. Now it would have removed that section. So I'm going to go preview. And this is how it looks. Let's go to full screen. It looks interesting. Very, very old styling, but it has a lot more features. If you see, you have layers. Okay, you have size, opacity, hardness. Preview, all right. Okay, what is preview? Okay, so we have the brush here. Canvas Studio. We have, the eraser. Shapes. Text, which is not there in the other one. We have a fill tool. We have a color picker tool. And I think we can move the canvas around as well. So we have, what is this? There is no tool tip used. We have a crop tool. We have a zoom tool. And this is probably grab. Okay, let's start here. Let's take the brush and I'm going to draw. Okay, I'm going to use this color. That works as well. Let's increase the size. Size works. Opacity, lower the opacity. And yes, the opacity does work and it is sensitive. Let's look at the hardness. What is hardness? Oh, nice. That's good. All right. So let's do one thing. This is not very visible. Let's click on add a new layer. That doesn't work. Okay. All right. So that's okay. I'm going to do one thing. Is there an option to clear the canvas here? There is no. Okay, there is something here, canvas. Okay, add something. Oh, wow. There is something called share and you can share it. All right. Then we have filters. Filters coming soon. Interesting. They've not even added the feature and yet effects coming soon. Interesting. All right. So we have the line, we can draw the line, the circle comes there. A lot more features in Claude 3.7 Sonnet, but it doesn't seem like a complete app. Okay, truly I was really, really impressed with Google Gemini 2.5 Pro, but when you compare it with Claude 3.7 Sonnet, especially in the chat interface, I just feel like Claude 3.7 Sonnet still does a better job. Kudos to Anthropic, because no matter how many new models comes up, for some reason, Claude does better at coding. We were really looking at the first prompt itself, but like I said, we can go in, ask the AI to add specific features with regards to design or functions and get something amazing. But to be frank, you have to appreciate the fact that with just one prompt, which was not even detailed, I didn't even ask it to provide all these features. I'm sure if I would have given these details in Gemini 2.5 Pro, if I would have told I need swatches, I need hardness, I need layers, all these things were added into the prompt, I'm sure Gemini 2.5 Pro also would have given us all of these features. But for some reason, Claude is able to understand what future features that we will need, and it is able to add that on its own. So I still think Anthropic is doing a better job giving us models that can code. But having said that, this is also really, really good. I mean, for Google, which had not a single model which was good at coding, this is a very, very big leap. And I'm really glad that it can do this. And in my experience, what I have tried earlier is that I was giving detailed prompts and it was actually adding everything that we were asking it to. So if we give a detailed prompt for Gemini 2.5 Pro, it will actually do really well and add all those features. And in the next video, I'm going to do exactly that. I'll give a very, very detailed prompt and see with just one single prompt how good of an output Gemini 2.5 Pro can give us. Okay, so if you'd like to watch more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, and I'll see you in the next one.